One of the problems across the nation this morning is skunks, lots of them from Southern California to the islands off Massachusetts. The skunk population has exploded, especially in suburban areas. Outside Magazine took a look at the summer of the skunk, and its executive editor, Sam Moulton, is here to tell us all about that. So, Sam, just when I'd gotten comfortable in complaining about hot weather, now I have to start complaining about skunks. I mean, they're everywhere right now.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, the population has been booming, and you know, skunks are a very adaptable little creature, and so there's a couple reasons for it. We've had a few warmer winters. This past one was cold, but some other ones have been warm, and so the population's going up. More of them live through the winter. They have larger litters. There's also been a drought out west, and so they think, wildlife biologists think that some of that has forced the skunks into the suburbs in search of food and water. And then in general, it's just more habitat and more food. Some cities have had to cut trash collection budgets, and so there's more trash around, and skunks are scavengers. So
skunks are an economic indicator here.
Yeah, yeah. They're definitely disruptive as well.
Well, so do we expect this to continue exploding? Because, I mean, we've even seen skunks show up at Dodger Stadium. New York City is reporting, you know, more skunk sightings.
Yep. Well, you know, the population ebbs and flows naturally, and so we'll probably see it dip down again. Sometimes what happens when the population goes up is that we get little outbreaks of rabies, and so that happens when the population spikes, and then the disease is transferred faster from animal to animal, and that helps knock the population back down.
What is the predator of a skunk?
Well, that's a good question. Yes, yeah, so they don't have that many natural predators because wolves, badgers, foxes are very reluctant to attack a skunk because they don't want to get sprayed. So their only real natural predators are great horned owls, red-tailed hawks, and that's because birds are less susceptible to smell than mammals.
Mm-hmm. So if you have a nuisance skunk in your backyard, what do you do?
Well, you definitely just want to stay away. I mean, they're very skittish. They don't want to spray you. And so and most skunks, of course, don't have rabies, so just, you know, leave them alone. They'll probably leave you alone. Of course, they're nocturnal as well, so you're most likely to see them in the evening.
For years, we have heard tomato juice, maybe oatmeal. People have all these remedies, but in the article, you talk about what is the real solution if you do get sprayed.
That's right, yeah. Tomato juice, oatmeal, those are urban myths. What you need is something that's going to break down the chemical composition of the spray. And so for clothing, they recommend 1 cup of bleach to 1 gallon of water just for clothing. But then if your dog gets sprayed, and that's what most likely is going to happen, more dogs get sprayed than people, they recommend 1 quart of 3% hydrogen peroxide, 1/4 cup of baking soda, and 1 teaspoon of liquid soap. And lather that into your dog. That's definitely the best solution.
The best solution is just stay away.
Yeah, stay away, exactly.
Sam Moulton, thanks so much for being with us this morning.